YouTube, Edgar here, and welcome to Artifexian. Here you will learn everything you ever wanted to know about world building, and then some. In the last video, we looked at the first element that goes into forming consonants, place of articulation. In this video, let's look at manner of articulation. Place of articulation tells us where in the mouth the obstruction to the airflow is occurring. Manner of articulation, listed on the side here, will tell us how much of the airflow is being obstructed. It's a roughly top-down kind of thing here, with total obstruction near the top and minimal obstruction near the bottom. In order, we have 1. Nasal stops. Instead of simply stopping the airflow, we can reroute it through the nasal cavity. This produces sounds like ma as in mouth and na as in nose. It's worth noting that nasal consonants are nearly universal in human language. Only languages around Puget Sound, Kwileryut, Hwalsukid, and Makah, truly lack nasal consonants. Number 2, plosives. Plosives, also known as stops, stop the airflow entirely. The pressure is built up behind the articulators and eventually released in a small explosion of air. English has 6 plosive consonants. Ba, pa, ta, da, ka, and ga. As in pan, ban, town, dog, king, and garden. Number 3, fricative. There are a lot of fricatives. Here the airflow is obstructed almost entirely, producing a turbulent hissing sound. In English, we have no less than 10 fricative sounds. Fa, va, tha, tha, sa, za, sha, ja, ha, and ha. As in fish, van, thought, this, so, zoo, shine, vision, loch, and home. Number 4, approximant. Here the airflow is impeded only slightly. The hissing sound, indicative of fricatives, is no longer present here, but the sound is altered to a degree. In English, we have 3 approximants. Ra, as in run, ya, as in yes, and wa, as in water. Interestingly, the English W sound does not appear in this section of the IPA. Why? Because it's co-articulated. So it belongs in this section, which we'll discuss in the near future. The TLDR here is that the English W sound occurs in 2 places at once. It's a velar approximant, but at the same time, it's also labialized. Hence, co-articulated. Further interesting side note is that theoretically we can labialize any sound with a superscript W after the relevant IPA symbol. So pa, ba, ta, and da, for example, will become poa, boa, toa, and doa. Number 5, tap or flap. There are only 3 taps or flaps in the IPA, none of which occur in standard English. The most familiar example of a tap or flap will be the North American realization of the word latter. Letter. Here the T sound is replaced by an alveolar flap. What's happening here is that one articulator is thrown against another in a single gesture, hence tap or flap. Number 6, trill. Here an articulator is held in place, and the air blown through the vocal tract causes it to vibrate back and forth. The IPA has 3 contrastive trills. Ra, as in the French rendezvous. Bra, a bra, as in the Nias word for lower jaw, si bruit, and of course the rolled or, which my stick figure friend will again demonstrate.
Ra, a ra.
And finally, number 7, laterals. So laterals are liquidy L-type sounds, produced when the tongue creates an obstruction in the middle of the mouth and reroutes the air out the sides of the mouth. Notice laterals come in 3 forms: lateral fricatives, lateral approximants, and lateral flaps. We have only 1 lateral sound in English, la, as in laugh. That said, we can't talk about the laterals without mentioning the voiceless lateral fricative, found in Icelandic, Welsh, and Navajo, amongst others. Hla, a hla, as in the Welsh pronoun, hlash, which is just the coolest sounding word. Anyways, to summarize, here is the IPA consonant chart, the columns represent place of articulation, where the obstruction is occurring, and the rows represent manner of articulation, how much of the airflow is being obstructed. Next up, voicing. Stay tuned. Good morning, Interweb. I hope you all enjoyed this video. Now, to break things up a little, the next video will be a collaboration between myself and Eric Lang of 30secfantasy.com. Over at 30secfantasy.com, Eric posts up a new original short story every day. A personal favorite of mine is Peanut. Links in the doobie-doo. Check it out, it's awesome, and it'll give you a taste of what to expect in the upcoming collaboration. As always, thank you all so much for watching. Edgar out.